ragioni per le quali ci rendiamo
We asked is so first of all if f of g is connected, it's still not known. So if you are thinking of interpolation, let me tell you that it's not easy.
So maybe it works, but it's not going to be easy.
So now so this is the one thing, and then the second one, well, I mean it kind of makes sense. If g is hyperbolic, is there any relation between this maximum, so is this a function of the conformal dimension of the boundary of the group? Okay, I forgot my convention. So of course right now again hyperbolic means finitely generated hyperbolic. So actually from now on I'd rather work with finitely generated groups. Of course the questions are pretty general. Right, so I mean this is just the basics. We'd like to understand this set and understand what features of the geometry of the group does it encode. And clearly the interesting case is the case of rank 1 with property T or hyperbolic with property T. And then the main source of hyperbolic groups with property T are random groups. So it is normal that we start looking now at random groups. Because as I mentioned before, that's where you find most of these examples. So if you want to discuss this, we'll have to look at random group theory. And there are essentially two models that are most popular. One can criticize them a lot. I mean, both are very imperfect in every possible way. That's all we have, and that's that. So the triangular model for random groups. Now this one, for many reasons, is much better whenever we look at fixed point properties, and that's why the first properties were proved in this model. The model is relatively easy to describe. So to begin with, we fix a parameter B, which we call density. So it's not 0, not 1, but in between. And then we consider an integer and we let it vary. So it essentially in the end is going to vary towards infinity. And then we consider, say, Sm, set of m generators. So it wants set of m letters. And then we consider Wn, the set of reduced, signically reduced words of length 3 in this alphabet and its inverse. So not really the cardinality of this is essentially, well, 2m power 3, I mean more or less. We know exactly what it is, but it's irrelevant for what I both you and I know for this randomness thing. So and in this model, so what we do is that we pick a subset in this set of cardinality of 2m power 3b uniformly at random. So all the subsets of this cardinality appear with equal probability, and then the model, the triangular model, sometimes denoted by and set up relay pairs up. And of course, this is no restriction. This just, I mean, it's clear that we're working with finite represented groups, and both motors are finite represented groups, of course, because those are countably many, and that's as much as we can do. This, of course, the fact that we are looking at groups with triangular representations is no real restriction, because all finite represented groups have triangular representations. So this is this model, and then we say that a property, a certain property, say P, holds asymptotically almost surely if when we look at the probability that the group gamma has P over all the groups for an M fixed, we want this probability to converge to 1 when M goes to infinity. So we're letting M go to infinity, and we look at what properties become generic in the assumption of this. All right, so there were a few, I mean, just to give you the picture, there were a few properties that were proved straight away by Abramov and Zuk, and they are as follows. So we know results. So first of all, if the density is too large, then asymptotically almost surely the group is trivial or zp. So that is not interesting. While if the density is less than a half, then asymptotically almost surely the group is in the hyperbolic. So I'll attribute this to now, as far as property T is concerned, this is also, the result was provided also rather straight away. If the density is larger than a third, then asymptotically almost surely gamma has P. While if you are below, then asymptotically almost surely gamma is a trivial. So this is it's accumulable and even of a very specific type. So for property T, it is 1/3 the place where things change. That means that between 1/3 and 1/2, the random groups are hyperbolic and with property P. So the kind of things that we want to look at precisely for the results that I wanted to mention. And here is what we proved. Log of n divided by log log n power over. Oh, and there is a constant c. So the larger the number of generators, the larger the range of FLP. So they get more and more fixed point properties for more and more LP spaces. I should also say that actually, so also true for FLP Lipschitz. Lipschitz in the sense of G1. Of the first generalization, where unfortunately the constant becomes worse and worse. So it's 2 to the power 1 over 2p. So all these properties, all these groups, hyperbolic with property p, moreover, have a fixed point property for p in a larger and larger interval, and for actions eventually not only isometric, but with uniformly bounded unitary part. But the bound has to be this one. And then this is true. Now, from this, we can deduce by some extra work some answer for the second.
So, Cornelia, in the statement of the first in the theorem there, what's M? Is M D or is it
no,
function
M
of D?
Is the generating set. M is this one. M is this one.
Okay, fine.
But what does it mean AAS then in that case? Because M is tended to infinity.
So, yes, that means the following. At the set M, I'm taking all the groups with this presentation. Among them, I'm counting those which have all the properties that are P between 0 and that bound. And that probability is going to go to infinity. It can't be better than this, because these groups are hyperbolic, so this interval is always going to be bound. I mean, for all of them, the interval is going to be bound. The only thing we can do is estimate the speed at which the upper bound increases. That's all we can do. So that's it. And yes, please tell me if you have further questions. Don't start thinking of lunch. Think of property P. It's much more important. Okay. So, So now let me bring. Okay. Maybe it's maybe the time to say that. So yeah, it's maybe the right point so to make the second remark. So this statement clearly answers Bourdon's question to find groups with property T such that that f of G is bounded, but it contains larger and larger interval. Nevertheless, this is not the first answer. So the answer to Bourdon's question had already been provided, so has been provided by Laur and Silverman. So they constructed groups. They constructed already groups with this property. What I mean to say is that we prove that this is actually a generic case. So almost every group represented has f of g bounded and contains larger and larger intervals. Now, concerning the second question, the question about the conformal dimension, what we found, again, it's me, we found the following thing, that, again, for every density between and a half, there exist two constants, actually, depending on the density, such that we have the following thing. If we look at this supremo, which is always smaller than the conformal dimension of the boundary by Bourdon, the lower bound same logarithm, but let me write logarithm so such that asymptotically, almost surely, gamma satisfies this sequence of inequalities. And here we have the same thing. We have the bound logarithm of m, or let's say a third minus m. Imagine it's the same thing. And its upper bound is logarithm of m, again the same constant, which in fact implies that we have at least two estimates. So first of all, here gamma is at least the conformal dimension, at most the conformal dimension, and at least one over k prime the conformal dimension, well, of a boundary. The boundary, a power, a third, minus epsilon. So it's not an inequality, but it does show that for the generic groups, hyperbolic, this supremum is in rather close connection to the conformal dimension of the boundary. Conjecturally, again, it's an inequality, but it's not. Actually, it's because I don't want to keep writing logarithm defined by my log logarithm. It's the dependent on my laziness only. But it's a small epsilon. So just to make the inequalities work more. Now, if we go to the other model, the Gromov density model. Now, unfortunately, so this one is actually even more popular than the other one, maybe because it's harder to prove things. and unfortunately, there are connections, but there is no immediate connection between this one and the other one. And so let's see. In this case, we again fix the density around the local poly density. Now we also fix the set of the generating set. And so therefore we fix S generating set. So of cardinality, using the cardinality. Okay. And this time we consider the set of cyclically reduced words of length L in S and S inverse. So therefore, it's, as usual, it's like essentially two k power L. And then again we pick a subset. The idea is the same, it's just power d of the previous. So we pick a subset. I'm so sorry, I keep writing the cardinality as the order is correct. So we pick this one uniformly at random among all the subsets of cardinality tk power dl. And then the model is composed, so let's call it GKL, is composed of groups in this presentation. And then we say that P is true asymptotically almost surely if. Now this time, when we count, so gamma has this property P, we fix the length, we count all the groups which have that property, and then we let the length go to infinity, and we want the probability to go to 1. And then we say that that the property holds asymptotically almost surely. And then what was known in this case, some of it reduced from the triangle. I should have learned this. I'm not going to write, I can do it, but it's another clue to the audience. Erased. I'd rather write on this board. So what is the model compared to the triangular model? Well, the first part, in fact, it's true, still true. So if this divergence is Gromov, though, so if the density is larger than a half, then gamma is trivial or is it 2? And if he is less than a half, it is hyperbolic. Now, if d is larger than a third, then gamma has property t. Now, okay, so for the triangular group, I think this should be attributed to zu, while for the other one, both zu and gamma. Now for t, so it's not as neat as before. So the only thing that can be said is that so the latest progress is that for d less than 1/5, gamma does not have t because it acts on a space with walls in unbounded orbit, and this is a result of I have to write the name of Piotr Krasinski. Something that nobody wishes to do with the I think it's correct.
Yeah. Got it.
And what happens in between is not known. It's an open question. And now, and our results as well, they're not as good. Not as good. So here's what we can prove.
It's a little better now. It's 5 over 24. I think a fifth is 94. Eight over 5 over 24.
Oh, you're right, actually.
Right.
So who did 1 over 5th?
Olivier.
Oh, you're right. Yeah. Okay, so 5 over 5. Yeah, okay, sorry. Thank you for
being here.
Sorry?
You would be quicker to write Olivia Wise.
Yes, but this is better. Thank you, I'm so sorry. All right, so this is and this is what we can do. I was thinking of how to write the name and I paid attention to the quality. Now, so what we can do is again for every gamma, for every d, and for every d, unfortunately, so well, of course, when it's even larger than 2, we have to prescribe a number of generators. So we have to ask that d is large enough. So this is not optimal, but this is what we have. And once we have that. The group gamma in the Gromov model for this k and for this density has all the properties fl p prime, fl p prime, well, it was between 0 and this p, asymptotically almost sure. So this time is not going to vary with the length. I mean, ideally, we would like to have some p increasing with the length. But we can't do this, and even this was a pain. That's all we can do. For every p, if the number of generators is large enough, we have these 6-point properties, and that's about it. Which means, again, I mean, one can say that the generator group in this case is hyperbolic with large conformal dimension, but not more. Now, for density smaller than 1/8, John has provided optimal estimate for conformal dimension, but for large densities, there isn't anything known. And so let me just make one remark. In fact, it's pure speculation. Just just went in on a kind of optimistic note. It's just starting from the following results, say, of Cornelier and Olivier, stating that if gamma is countable with property P, then gamma is a function of some gamma 1 hyperbolic of property P. So this means that somehow, if one manages to construct some consistent theory of random countable groups that is also consistent with the previous one, there is every reason to expect that the generic case will be of groups which are functions of hyperbolic groups with more and more of the fixed point properties. So somehow one is ready to believe that that this is actually the generic situation.